Okay, so I've got a clear liquid here and a different clear liquid here. And I'm gonna add a white powder to this one, get some bubbles. And then a different white powder to this one, also getting some bubbles, but they look a bit different. Now while these are sitting around, I'm gonna hop over here and get a water bath up to about 75 degrees Celsius. And now I'm gonna take both of these, which have stopped bubbling, and put them in this water bath, wait a few minutes for them to come up to temperature, and wait, what? Where are these extra bubbles coming from? All right, so you've probably guessed that the liquid in this bowl was vinegar and that the white powder was baking soda. So you also know the bubbles are carbon dioxide. In this bowl, the clear liquid was just plain old water, and the powder was a mixture of baking soda, monocalcium phosphate, and cornstarch. You know this mixture as double-acting baking powder, and it's quite different than that other white powder, baking soda. Here's how. Baking powder contains at least one solid acid, in this case, monocalcium phosphate. It also contains a solid base, almost always baking soda, also known as sodium bicarbonate. The acid and base react with each other when water is added to produce carbon dioxide gas. But we waited for this reaction to finish. In other words, we waited for all the acid and the base to react with each other. So where are these extra bubbles coming from? Well, it turns out that the acid doesn't actually dissolve very much in water. So while the baking powder is just sitting here at room temperature, most of the acid doesn't react with the base. Heat helps the acid dissolve more in water, which means more of it will react with the baking soda, which means more CO2 is produced, which means more bubbles. There may also be other reasons heating makes more CO2 depending on which baking powder you use, but that's a long and convoluted story involving Henry's Law and Le Chatelier's principle, so we'll cover that in another video. With cookies next time, I think. Cookies. Anyway, this is where the double acting thing comes from. It acts once out here in the batter, and then it acts again in the oven. By the way, almost all baking powder sold today is double acting. Thanks for watching, and if a chemistry question bubbles up in your brain, let us know in the comments. PBS Digital Studios is conducting its annual audience survey. This survey is one of the most important projects we do every year because it helps us understand who you are and what you like and what you don't like, beyond what we can see in our analytics. 35,000 responses last year helped us make decisions on what experiments to try, what experiments to not try, and even what shows to make. If you have a few minutes, please click the link below. 25 random participants will receive an awesome PBSDS t-shirt. And as always, click right here to subscribe and click that alarm bell to get notified every time we raise a new video. See you next week.